Wait, so where are you from? It's a question people receive on a daily basis, but especially true for international students. Coming from all over the world, about 1.1 million international students were enrolled in U.S. institutions in the school year of 2019-2020. In that same year, Jacksonville University reported that 7% of the total student body is international, with the number still growing every year. And all of them moved to the U.S. for many different reasons.
The reason why I moved to the U.S. was because my parents believed that there was a better education for me here in the U.S. and they believe that English is the most important thing that you can learn. That's why I came to the U.S.
It was a better lifestyle. In South Africa, you can't really, no matter how rich you are, how poor you are, safety is always a concern. You can't buy protection. Whereas in America, rich or poor, you have some level of safety that you can't get in South Africa.
I primarily decided to come to the U.S. to play golf. It's something I've always wanted to do. I've seen it like on movies, people come to the U.S., do their sport, and I just thought it was something I would really want to give it a go myself.
I only applied for JU because my mom had been there before for like twice, and she just loved this school and loved the city, and she kind of showed me the pictures she took here, and I also love here.
South Africa's political situation has been really rough, and my family has been encouraging me to leave the country as soon as I could, and I figured that going to the United States would be a great opportunity for that.
I would consider like England my home, but then when I'm in England, I call like Florida my home. So it's kind of strange. It depends on where I am. Like, it's like having two homes.
I consider that I have a family in Spain, but I also have a family in the U.S. I'm like kind of divided. It's like half of me is Spanish, half of me is from the U.S.
I have been learning English in school. It's just like as a course. But it's not like native English, it's not like daily, it's not a daily language we use in China, but it's more like book knowledge.
It was kind of frustrating the first like month or two, because I didn't know English, so like how I'm going to communicate. But I met this guy called Charlie, and like Charlie was like, hey, tell me, like, let's go to the movies, let's do this, let's do that. I'm like, cool, let's do it. I like, by hanging out with him, by hanging out with people in the school, I just was able to learn. And like 2 months after I was here, I started dreaming in English. And I believe that once you start dreaming in English, that's when you know you like knowing.
The U.S. was a movie-like world. It was insane. You know, when I first came here, everything was the movies. It was surreal to say. I couldn't believe people actually live these kinds of lifestyles.
When you watch movies, I'm basing mine on like movies like Pitch Perfect. You don't see like there's like the difference between the big schools and the small schools. So I was expecting to come to this like huge, huge school like in Pitch Perfect.
But like the first impression is everything is just so big. Like the houses, the roads, even people. And the clothes and everything, they're like bigger size in China. And when I came back to China, I feel like everything is so small.
Before I moved here, I believed it to be land of the free, everybody's happy. I had a perception that the entirety of the United States was Disney World, so.
I didn't know what to think about the US. Like, you see it in the movies and you're like, that's fake. There's no way. There's no way that's gonna be like that. And then you actually come here and you're like, but this is like the movies, like what's going on? They have the same cars, they act the same way, like what?
South Africa is either viewed as a very rural, third world, tumbleweeds rolling in the distance kind of place, or they see it as this wonderland. I asked my former roommate how she felt when she found out I was from South Africa, and she said that she was incredibly shocked that I didn't line up with what she thought a South African would look like or act like. She was imagining tribal people riding lions, living in huts, which isn't really the truth anywhere in Africa anymore. Well, in South Africa anymore.
I think the stereotype I normally face is the typical African stereotype of, oh, you ride lions and you ride elephants, and how did you get here? Because planes don't exist. And how are your houses? Are they still made out of clay and poo? And, you know, I've heard very interesting comments. I kind of just take them on the chin. I know there's a small percentage of Americans that are uneducated towards where South Africa is, or even where the continent of Africa is.
Every day I go somewhere and they're like, oh, where are you from? Spain. Oh, all the Spaniards are the same. Oh, why are you doing that? No, that's a Spanish thing. I think it's funny. I think it's really funny because I love being a stereotype. I love when people say, you are from Spain. I'm like, yes, I am. And I am proud of it. And I'm happy of it.
I did have a situation occur when I was in Indiana once. I was at a Point Blank, it's a gun range, and I didn't have my passport with me because I wasn't aware that they needed a form of identification, but I did have my South African driver's license. And after showing the gentleman my South African driver's license, he then pulled out a list of countries that are legally allowed to shoot within the country, and South Africa was not on there. So I had to sit back and watch all my friends continue on to the shooting range, because I couldn't participate.
When I have a negative react, I talk to them. Like, I don't have a problem talking to them. I talk to everyone. So when they say, tell me that, I'm like, no, man, I'm sorry to tell you, but like, you are wrong. This is not how it is. And I talk to them, and if I need to spend an hour and a half talking to them to change their mind, I will spend an hour and a half. And I have never had the problem of living somewhere thinking that that person still thinks that the Spaniards are horrible people.
Yeah, you get. I think the English accent, you get a lot of positive like remarks. People like the accent, they like to talk to you, so it's nice.
People always say like, oh, so you speak Chinese, can you teach me some Mandarin, like things like that. I'd always love to do that.
People who know a few places in South Africa know that the nature there is absolutely beautiful. We have incredible coastlines and mountains, and people who know that get very excited when I say I'm from South Africa, and they ask me about the marine life, they ask me about the mountains, they ask me about the fynbos.
So how my professors at JU treat me was actually really cool. They treat me like another student. They treat me like another student, but they also knew that if I needed something, like I wasn't to ask. Because I had a personal connection with them. I went and talked to them. I went and like asked them questions. And once you make a connection with someone like that, if you go to them and you're like, hey, like, I know I did this wrong in this exam, or like, I didn't know the word here. And once they realize that it's true that like, I just blocked, and like, I couldn't say the word, because that sometimes happens. Like, that happens to us quite a bit. And they were like, okay, you know, like, it's going to be okay. I can fix it.
Well, I think they treat me really nice, and maybe I'm international, they will pay more attention on me. Like, they will easily remember my name, although it's really hard to pronounce.
I think a lot of professors give me, not different treatment, but I think a lot of them have, especially in the business world, have been to England, have traveled, they're always asking questions about it. So I do think I get a little bit of favoritism, but not a lot.
Since being here, I've realized that just like anybody else, Americans are just people. And even though culturally they may be more welcoming, less welcoming, however the situation may be, there's going to be so many differences in what people know and what they don't. I had a perception that Americans didn't know anything about the rest of the world, and some of them don't, but some of them do. And it's kind of given me a lot more global awareness to the variability of people.
Before I came to America, I thought that Americans, and I didn't think too much, that they didn't know what they were doing, that they were all fat, and that they all wanted to eat fast food. But I have learned that people here are like highly educated. So I learned that not everyone is the same. Not everyone wants the same things. Everyone is different.
When I graduate, part of me wants to stay here. The headquarters of the PGA Tour is like situated like in Jacksonville, so I'd love to do that, but I also may go home because I really miss my family. I want to be a bit closer to them and just carry on working in the golf industry.
After JU, I think my highest probability is going to stay in the United States. I have considered some options in Europe because I know certain countries are giving citizenship if you have a computer science major.
I'm not going back to South Africa. I was considering moving somewhere else. I was looking at Western Europe and potentially Canada. But given my qualifications at present, I think I'm going to go to grad school somewhere in the States. But I am officially leaving Florida.
I plan to go to graduate school in England. Yeah, I'm actually applying for some schools there. I kind of want to go to London, so I applied for UCL, and I also applied for schools in Manchester.
Things I really want is to get my green card, so I can go wherever I want in the world and just come back here and be like, I can actually start a life. Like when I'm 45, I can be like, I can go to the US because I have my green card, and I can actually like buy a house and be a citizen of this country. And I think it's, without a doubt, one of the greatest countries in the world. So that's why I want that.